Can machines really think? Even the scientists argue that one.
I'm convinced that machines can and will think in our lifetime.
I confidently expect that within a matter of 10 or 15 years, something will emerge from the laboratories which is not too far from the robot of science fiction fame.
Augsburg in southern Germany, home to the headquarters of KUKA, the world's leading manufacturer of industrial robots. Rainer Bischoff is head of research here and is considered to be one of the world's leading experts in this field. He and his team are working on a new generation of robots that learn independently, like children. The task? To recognize and sort building blocks.
This robotic system taught itself how to grab. In other words, there was no human programming the robot.
So he tried by himself?
He tried by himself, like a child. When he first started grabbing, he wasn't successful, except for in 1 to 2% of cases. But he observed himself. And by observing himself, the robot identified when an image successfully matched a particular grasping motion and when it didn't. He's applied what he learned, and now he can successfully grab these objects over 90% of the time. I didn't program him, and yet he's still learning the task by himself. Seeing that really motivates you.
But what if the robot sees a new object, such as pliers?
It's a nice example. Every child would just say, okay, grab and move those pliers over, no problem. But he's still failing.
He's failing because he doesn't know what kind of inertial force this object has to be able to grab it properly. But you can see how he's already trying out different methods, and in time, he may get the hang of it. I should add that he isn't trained after every attempt. He collects around 1,000 data, and then the neural net is retrained. So it's possible that if we let him try 1,000 times, now he would at least be able to grab them reliably.
Intelligent robots that learn by themselves. They can recognize parts, assemble them, and they can independently adapt to their environment with the help of AI. But we're only in the early development stages.
I have a favorite example, and that's chess. These days, there are computers or AI that can beat chess champions. But we don't have a robot that can reach into a bookcase, take out a chess set, open the box, take out the pieces one by one, set them up, and start playing. A six-year-old can do that, but no existing robot can. So for the moment, whenever I need physical intelligence, we're still doomed to fail. And I think that will be the case for a few more years.
Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Justin with the Chapel on the Rock. Welcome. I hope you're doing well, and thank you for joining me today because I've got quite a few clips I want to play for you. I've been doing a lot of research on the Mark of the Beast, transhumanism, artificial intelligence, and the Antichrist, just to name a few things. Of course, always pray for discernment, do your own research. I'm not claiming to be an expert on anything. I'm just another person following Jesus Christ and trying to expose evil and trying to lead people to him before humanity starts to really fall apart. The satanic agendas we will be discussing today have been put out in plain sight. They've been shown to us in movies, music videos, halftime shows, opening ceremonies, cartoons, things of that nature. The enemy of humanity, Lucifer, has put the truth right out in front of the masses, and most of them, almost all of them, can't see it. In the meantime, those of you who are awake are ringing the alarm bells for multiple things and praying for your family members, co-workers, and friends, praying for other truthers as our voices are censored and silenced, because right now humanity is stumbling towards a precipice as it continues to play around with technologies that will spell its demise, like artificial intelligence, DNA modification, nanotechnology, transhumanism, black programmable matter, and cloning. And the more you research these topics, the more you realize Lucifer is helping mankind open up doors it will not be able to shut. And one of the biggest agendas that's out there is to corrupt the temple of God. And on the face of the earth, what is the temple of God? Well, 1 Corinthians 3:16 through 17 reads, "Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and that temple you are." So men and women, those are God's temples here. That's where God dwells. And transhumanism, as well as trying to merge with artificial intelligence, are ways to destroy those temples. Those are ways to destroy one's relationship with God or one's potential relationship with God. And at some point, transhumanism will be a requirement to remain a part of the world. People will be marked with it. People will need to augment their bodies. They will need to merge with technology to be able to interact with the coming one-world digital currency, the mark of the beast. And once they do that, they will be connected to the beast system, a satanic one-world government. And at that point, they will be in very bad standing with God, as you know, the worst type of standing. And any of you who know what it's like to turn your life over to Jesus Christ and receive his forgiveness, love, and mercy, and to experience what it's like being right with God and at peace with God, know that that's a relationship not worth sacrificing for anything. And being able to buy and sell in a corrupt economy is something that a lot of us believers will not do. I mean, we all make mistakes. None of us are perfect. But I believe transhumanism is a mistake one doesn't come back from. The mark of the beast is something no one comes back from. In other words, it should be avoided at all costs. And hopefully you're thinking this is common sense. We are the way the Creator, the true Creator, made us, and that's the way we are supposed to be. If you were born as a man, you come into this world as a man, you die as a man. Or if you're born into this world as a woman, you die as a woman. And along your journey, you're blessed and lucky if you get to discover how real Jesus is and get the chance to follow him. And the mark of the beast, in my opinion, will be more than just a mark to buy and sell. It will include things that make it look very attractive. People are going to want it. It's going to be offered as an improvement to society, to the masses. I think it's going to be offered as an upgrade. I also think people will be afraid that they won't be able to keep up with artificial intelligence and society unless they evolve with technology, merge with technology. But like I said, I'm not claiming to be an expert. Always pray for discernment. Always turn to God and ask him for answers. Always do your own research. But even if I'm not an expert, there are some things I know for fact, including that if someone wants to upgrade themselves, they should do that through Jesus Christ. If someone wants to improve themselves, they should do that through Jesus Christ, in prayer and in trying their best to follow him. And if someone doesn't like who they are, whether they believe me or not, there is a God in heaven who cares for them the way they were created, and a Savior who is waiting for them to call upon his name. Amen. But unfortunately, the prince of this age has done a great job of blinding people and deceiving them. I mean, we all grew up in a system that began lying to us at a very young age, teaching us fake science and fake history. a system that got most people worshiping the creation instead of the creator, a system that got most people wanting to evolve, a system that made Jesus Christ in biblical history look like foolishness, a system that right now has most people right where the devil wants them, uncovered by the sacrifice of Jesus and ready to tamper with the temple of God, ready to upgrade or augment their bodies. But enough of me rambling, my friends. Let's look at some clips. These clips I'm going to play for you first are from the trailer for a movie called Outside the Wire, released on Netflix in January of 2021, and I'll be right back.
Sir, looking for Captain Leo.
You must have really messed up if they sent you to Leo.
Do you know why you're here?
Yeah, because I broke chain of command.
Harp, he's not like us.
You're up.
You're commanding officer. Let me give you 60 seconds to deal with it.
Yes, sir.
Cool.
What are you, AI?
A Gump's AI. I'm a prototype, and my existence is classified. But I can't do this alone. I need someone who can think outside the box. That's why you're here. I chose you.
So in this movie, they normalize artificial intelligence in the military. There are robots that mimic dogs walking around the bases, and robotic soldiers called Gumps. Then we are shown something better than artificial intelligence as we currently know it. We are shown something that is better than us also. This high-tech individual towards the end of the movie calls himself a cyborg. The definition of a cyborg is a person whose physical abilities are extended beyond normal human limitations by mechanical elements built into the body. In other words, part man, part machine, that's a cyborg, and they are glorifying it. They are glorifying to the audience a new type of temple, a new type of body. You see this over and over again in movies now. They're planting the idea that in order to be part of the future, in order to survive and thrive with what's coming, you have to be something better than what you are now. You have to be something better than a regular human. I also felt this movie was aimed towards African Americans. They are pre-programming all the different demographics. They want all cultures, races, and nationalities indoctrinated and on board with what's coming. And another example of this broad indoctrination is the Russian TV series called Better Than Us, otherwise translated as Better Than People. And what's better than an ordinary person? What's better than a regular human? In this case, an artificial intelligence robot, one that blows away artificial intelligence as we know it now. They show us a lot of mediocre artificial intelligence here, but this new robot is not only better than all the pre-existing robots, it is smarter, stronger, faster, and seemingly more attractive than all the other characters in this show. They also paint this robot as the perfect addition to a Russian family, normalizing robots in the home. And what's better than a household with robots in reality? A household with no robots, all right? A household with some ordinary people, maybe a couple of pets, and of course the presence of Jesus Christ among them. Just saying. This show also works to normalize sex bots, or sex robots. Men are dating these things in this TV series, and it's disgusting. God created man and woman to cleave together, to bond together in marriage. That is his design. Any other type of sexual union is an unholy union, and God isn't too keen with unholy things, as I'm sure you know. Plenty of that in the Bible. Also, in this TV series, they are prepping people for the mark of the beast. They're getting people ready for transhumanism. Hardly anyone has a cell phone or any type of wallet in this show. Their smartphones and their wallets look like they are part of their forearms. They are normalizing the mark of the beast. Here people buy things with their forearms. They receive emails on their forearms. They look at bank information on their forearms. And they can play 3D games being projected from their forearms. Also, this doesn't look like it's something forced on people. It's an upgrade. And this is very similar to the smart mark shown in the Netflix cartoon called Stretch Armstrong and the Flex Fighters, aimed at younger demographics. Like I said, they are hitting all demographics with this. And if you're looking at the world right now and thinking it's black versus white, or Russians versus Americans, or even Democrats versus Republicans, you're missing the real battle. you're distracted at best or completely lost, especially if you're into racism or something, because this is a battle for the temple of God. It's Lucifer versus humanity. Sometimes I look at it too, like it's the 99% versus the 1%. The 1% being the elites who follow Lucifer and consider him an angel of light. That's why I'm praying for unity among the 99% working class to stick together and behind Jesus Christ. He is the only safe place for what's coming. He is the only hope. I'll say that today, and I'll keep saying that when things get really bad. And in these information sources I just mentioned, like I said, the mark of the beast doesn't look like something forced on people so they can buy and sell in some dystopian society. It looks like these human upgrades are being marketed to the masses as an improvement, as a better way of life. And people who reject the mark of the beast, people who reject transhumanism, they will be looked at as fools. Even though they are smart, they will be looked at as fools. They will be shamed and scorned by a world that's perishing. A world that wants to achieve things like eternal life without doing things God's way. And if you look at multiple scriptures in the Bible, if you look at where the world is headed, and you look at everything we were being shown in so-called entertainment, you could definitely say that artificial intelligence and transhumanism are a part of humanity's dark fate. A dark fate we will be seeing in our lifetimes. A dark fate that will help enslave and condemn the masses. And a dark fate we should definitely be on the lookout for. We don't want to get caught up in it. So let's read Revelation 14:9 through 11 real quick and see why. It says, "And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, If any man worship the beast and his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascendeth up for ever and ever, and they have no rest, day nor night, who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name." And I don't know about you, but I'm not trying to see God angry. When you're doing things right, God is love, amen. But he is putting out some stern warnings in the end of days. Don't play around with a forbidden fruit. Don't play around with transhumanism. Don't worship the Antichrist. Don't play around with the world's dark fate. Dark Fate also happens to be the name of a movie with a lot of interesting information embedded in it. The latest of the Terminator series of movies. First off, this movie shows us a lot of black programmable matter. Something we've been shown in a lot of transhumanism movies. Something I think we will see in our lifetimes for sure. They also show us a lot of one-eye symbolism in this movie. The Eye of Lucifer. The all-seeing eye. There are multiple occurrences of that. This movie also does a lot to glorify transhumanism, to program people to want it, or to plant the seed that people are going to need transhumanism in the future. Here is one of the heroes of this movie, a transhuman woman working to try to save humanity.
Are you a machine too?
No, I'm human like you.
But your arm...
Augmented.
And here is one more clip of her.
What are you? Never seen one like you before. Almost human.
I am human. Just enhanced. You know, increased speed and strength, thorium microreactor.
I also want to point out that this is a female, but they gave her several male characteristics. Short hair, muscular, manly, and tough. Transgenderism is a precursor to transhumanism. Just like you are currently seeing transgenderism pushed on humanity and people taking part in it, someday you will be seeing an even bigger push for transhumanism and even more people taking part in that. When transhumanism gets here, it's going to hit humanity really fast and really hard. I remember back around 2011, I knew one person who had a smartphone, and then I left the U.S. and went to Central America for about a year and 9 months. Then when I got back to the U.S., it seemed like 99% of the people had a smartphone. I maybe knew one person who didn't, me. That's how fast new technologies can hit society. And when transhumanism becomes mainstream, I suspect there will be just as big as a move towards it, towards modifying the temple of God. But now, continuing on with this movie. They also show us robots replacing jobs. Here's a quick clip of that.
There's a new guy at my station.
I see that.
Robot? Que chido, eh?
Losing jobs to AI, that is of course coming. Uber drivers, truck drivers, call center employees, to name a few, those will be some of the first jobs to go, and then many more. I mean, they are already working on construction robots. Some of them can hang drywall already. AI will take a massive amount of jobs as it arrives. And if people want government assistance when they lose their jobs in the future, of course they are going to need the Mark of the Beast. Another thing I found interesting about this movie is that the humans and this transhuman woman are battling an AI system built for cyber warfare, an artificial intelligence system gone wrong, one that turned on humanity. And in this movie, this AI system is named Legion. Legion is a reference to demons. Just check out these scriptures. Mark chapter 5, verses 6 through 9, talks about a demon-possessed man coming into contact with Jesus. Jesus casts the demon out of the man, and when doing this, he asks the demon its name, and it replies, "My name is Legion, for we are many." So an AI system built for cyber warfare is referenced with demons. Very interesting, as well as disturbing. Also, there is currently an AI system like Legion being developed right now by the Pentagon, and it's called Project Maven. Here's a short article segment about this project for you if you haven't heard about it. Project Maven, for those unfamiliar, is a Pentagon program to build an AI-powered surveillance platform for unmanned aerial vehicles. Basically, the job is to build a system for the U.S. military to deploy and monitor autonomous drones. This system would, supposedly, give the government real-time battlefield command and control and the ability to track, tag, and spy on targets without human involvement. Google had been working on this for the Pentagon, but many employees there signed a petition to stop it, and several employees walked out of Google because of the ethical concerns related to Project Maven. So Google quit working on it, but the project got picked up by another company called Palantir, which doesn't look to see any ethical dilemmas with it, and is probably working on it while you are watching this. But returning to this movie, a few more interesting things worth mentioning include things like this transhuman woman sacrifices herself so humanity can have a chance. She makes a Jesus Christ-like sacrifice, glorifying herself to the audience, glorifying transhumanism. There are many other movies where a transhuman character makes a Jesus Christ-like sacrifice, like Iron Man in the Avengers Endgame movie, and Matt Damon in the transhumanism movie Elysium. Also, it is interesting that in this movie, this transhuman woman's name is Grace. And why is her name Grace? I believe that is a biblical reference also. Ephesians 2, 8 through 9 states, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourself. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast." We are saved by the grace of God and through faith in Jesus Christ. That's how someone truly gets saved. You can't work your way into salvation. No technological type work or some man-made religious process will save you. You have to do that through Jesus. But Lucifer wants to offer humanity, the masses, a new type of grace. Lucifer wants to offer humanity an alternative to God's plan, transhumanism. That's why they called this transhuman woman Grace. I hope you who are watching this right now knows which Grace is the real Grace. And moving on, let's take a quick look at the beginning of the 2021 Super Bowl halftime show. Super Bowl halftime shows these days are basically Luciferian festivals. And to start this one off, we see something coming down from the sky. Revelation chapter 9, verse 1 reads, "And the fifth angel blew his trumpet, and I saw a star fallen from heaven to earth, and he was given the key of the shaft of the bottomless pit." A star, an angel, descends from heaven here. And as you see this angel or star descend, in the background, you see things that look like humans, but they also look like robots. A bunch of hive mind zombie robots is what they look like to me. And they look to be housed in a city, a giant mega city. And continuing on, Revelation 9:2 reads, "And he opened the bottomless pit, and there arose a smoke out of the pit, as the smoke of a great furnace, and the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. A gate or a shaft looks to open here, and it looks like the light of a furnace behind it, and smoke comes out. I think evil is putting the truth in plain sight here. There are going to be cyborgs housed in megacities, and God's judgment is coming. They show us later the city looks to be on fire. They also put this weird image on the display screen during this performance. It looks to me like some type of otherworldly destruction or something. And I might as well read the rest of what happens when the fifth trumpet blows. This might give us an idea as to why we are seeing otherworldly type destruction. So continuing on with verse 3. Then locusts came from the smoke and descended on the earth, and they were given the power to sting like scorpions. They were told not to harm the grass or plants or trees, but only the people who did not have the seal of God on their foreheads. And what can I say here but seek the presence of Jesus Christ in your life? No one will get the seal of God in this dispensation without him. And continuing on to the next verse. They were told not to kill them, but to torture them for 5 months, with pain like the pain of a scorpion sting. In those days, people will seek death, but will not find it. They will long to die, but death will flee from them. Verse 6 has always made me think of someone who has become a host body for evil, a ghost in a shell, you could say, unfortunately. And what can we do but expose evil and try to point people towards Christ? And continuing on. The locusts looked like horses prepared for battle. They had what looked like gold crowns on their heads, and their faces looked like human faces. They had hair like woman's hair, and teeth like the teeth of a lion. They wore armor made of iron, and their wings roared like an army of chariots rushing into battle. Sometimes when I think about these locusts described here, I think about advanced demonic military drones, or something with jet engines, or attack helicopters, but still not completely sure what they will be. I wouldn't be surprised, though, if they were some type of demonic modern attack helicopter. And continuing on, they had tails that stung like scorpions, and for 5 months they had the power to torment people. Their king is the angel from the bottomless pit. His name in Hebrew is Abaddon, and in Greek, Apollyon, the destroyer. Some sobering scriptures here, and I do think the church will be here for this. I don't think the rapture happens until the seventh trumpet, the last trumpet. Also, just looking at these hive mind looking, half human, half robots, and thinking about the rapture and the Antichrist makes me want to bring up 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 1 through 4 real quick, which reads, "Now concerning the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling to meet him, the rapture, we beg you, brethren, not to be quickly shaken in mind or excited, either by spirit or by word, or by letter purporting to be from us, to the effect that the day of the Lord has come." Paul was writing this because the Thessalonians had been told they'd missed the return of Jesus and the rapture. And then he goes on, "Let no one deceive you in any way, for that day will not come unless the rebellion comes first, and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the son of perdition." I take the son of perdition to be the Antichrist. In other words, Jesus will not return until we first get to see the Antichrist. God is going to let people decide if they want to worship the Antichrist or not. And he is going to let people decide if they want to take the mark of the beast or not. And those things occur before Jesus returns. Then, verse 4 continues on talking about the Antichrist, which reads, "Who opposes and exalts himself against every so-called God or object of worship, so that he takes his seat in the temple of God, proclaiming himself to be God." And you can take this as my personal opinion if you want, but I think at some point, the Antichrist will, to some degree, dwell in human bodies, which are God's temples here on the face of the earth right now. The Antichrist might sit in a rebuilt temple in Jerusalem, if it is some type of technological hub. But look at it like this. God knows what we are thinking and feeling all the time. He knows where we are headed next and where we have just been. He can even change our hearts. Obviously, he has access to our minds and our hearts. How can the Antichrist proclaim to be God unless he can do similar things with his people, unless he has access to his people, has access to them via technology, the mark of the beast? But like I said, do your own research and pray for discernment. seek God in His opinion, and study His Word, the Bible. Just like any video I make, for anything I get right, all glory goes to God. And for anything I get wrong, well, that's all on me. That's why I tell people I'm no expert, and I didn't go to seminary school. As a matter of fact, I don't place much value on schools anymore. In the past, I got a bachelor's degree and a master's degree relating more to science, but now I look at colleges as Jesuit Freemasonic brainwashing facilities. Just saying. At this point, they look to be a complete waste of time and resources. But moving on, there's a lot more one could say about this halftime show, performed by the singer Weekend, a performer for the spiritually weakened, right? That's what his name means to me. This guy is clearly satanic. But I wanted to move on to talk about a music video with Katy Perry in it called Z365, and also a bit about Freemasonry. Both interesting subjects. Katy Perry is used to put a lot of information out there. So let's move on to this video. It starts out at an international AI robotics center. We see a bunch of scientists who look to have a Z on their lab coats, but this is really a serpent. It's a snake, one of Lucifer's signatures. Then they show us Katy Perry, who plays an AI robot in this video. She, of course, looks human, but she has technology inside of her. She also has Mark of the Beast symbolism on her forehead in this video. I think AI will play some type of role with the Mark of the Beast. In Revelation 13:16, it says you can get the Mark of the Beast in your right hand or in your forehead. I think people who try to merge their minds with artificial intelligence using technologies like Elon Musk's Neuralink device will have the Mark of the Beast in their forehead. In the 2013 transhumanism movie called Elysium, they showed us a character with a first-generation Neuralink device way before Neuralink officially announced it, and this character had Mark of the Beast symbolism on his forehead. Now the Neuralink device has been improved upon. Elon Musk said that Neuralink will be like a Fitbit in your skull with tiny wires. And then I think the mark in the right hand will be similar to what I showed you earlier in the Russian TV show, Better Than Us, and also in Stretch Armstrong and the Flex Fighters. But like I've said, I'm not getting any type of mark to buy and sell. I'd rather go live in a tent and beg God for food than take part in any of the coming nonsense. But getting back to this video, I also think they're giving us a clue here that the Mark of the Beast will have some seductive characteristics. People are going to want it. To certain demographics, it will probably be marketed as being sexy or something to some degree. Also, I want to point out that these people with serpents on their lab coats dress Katy Perry in something that looks like one of her favorite types of outfits, something with an Illuminati Freemasonic checkerboard pattern on it. There are three types of symbolism you find this Illuminati star associated with a lot. Number one being the Freemasonic Illuminati checkerboard pattern. Number two, the all-seeing eye, which is the eye of Lucifer. And number three, the monarch butterfly, representing part of the MKUltra mind control program, which a lot of these people are victims of. And I just want to show you this for a bit too. This is a Freemasonic tracing board. You could call this a visual aid for the Freemason religion if you wanted to. You can only run into so much checkerboard symbolism and all-seeing eyes before you have to research them. And in doing so, this is one of the places you'll end up. I really looked at this tracing board and asked God, so what are these people into, God? Where are they going with all this stuff? And this is what I've come to based off of the research that led to. And first off, they have East at the top of this. You will find the East as a direction being very significant in Freemasonry. And the direction East is very significant to them because in Genesis chapter 3 in the Bible, Adam and Eve transgressed against God and were kicked out of the Garden of Eden to the East. They transgressed against God and they left traveling East. Now Freemasons want to continue to travel east. They want to continue to transgress against God and go their own way. And who do the Freemasons want to be free from? They want to be free from God. They want to continue to be both good and evil, dark and light. They don't want to follow rules from the Creator or do things His way, even though His way is the best way. Also, they look at the creator, at the real God as being evil. They believe in several different mystery religions, including Freemasonry, that Adam and Eve were being held captive in the Garden of Eden, and that Lucifer came and set them free with sacred knowledge and with sacred teachings. And they believe Lucifer is a good guy and that he is the angel of light. Lucifer, the light bearer, is how they see him, and they have been deceived into following him and looking for a new type of grace, one with no rules, and one where they could possibly become gods themselves, one where they are looking to change their bodies with technological alchemy. Also, you see the black and white checkerboard symbolism here. One thing it represents is duality. A simple definition of duality is the quality or state of having two different or opposing parts or elements. Like I said, they want to be both dark and light, good and evil, but they also use this as a part of their philosophy to change societies. They love to come into a community, an organization, a nation, or even the world and create a black and a white, a good and an evil, two opposing sides where they control both sides. They have those two sides battle one another and they lead the outcome, and they are masters at this. They are very skilled at this. A house divided against itself cannot stand. This also has a lot to do with what's called the Hegelian dialect, creating a thesis and an antithesis, controlling the battle, and eventually leaving them with a final result that they desired in the first place. We've seen this a lot with false flag attacks, staged events, psyops, and even politics. Also, the checkerboard symbolism represents as above, so below. Sacred teachings from above to below. There are 88 constellations in the sky. Chessboards purposefully have 8x8 sides to go with this. Pianos have 88 black and white keys. These are by Freemasonic design. High-ranking Freemasons are very influential, to say the least. You see Mason on the back of a $1 bill, of course, with what people think is the Star of David. Also, to see how influential Masons are, just look at the Fahrenheit temperature system that America uses. It's Freemasonic. With the Fahrenheit system, water is still frozen at 32 degrees, and then at 33 degrees, it changes, it melts, it becomes fluid, capable of more things. In Freemasonry, for a 32nd degree Mason to become a 33rd degree Mason, they have to reject Jesus Christ and accept Lucifer as their God. When they do this, they become more fluid. They are no longer frozen. They are free from the Creator. They are capable of more things. Freemasonry seems innocent in the early degrees, but becomes clearly satanic as one moves up the system. Also, looking at this tracing board, you see two front pillars, one with an S on it and another with a B on it. Then you see a W on the pillar towards the back. The S stands for strength and the B stands for beauty, one being a male characteristic and the other being a female characteristic. They believe when you combine these, when you combine male and female characteristics, you move towards wisdom, which is what the W stands for on the back pillar. And also, as you move through the Freemason system, you move towards transcendence as well. You see a ladder in the back that represents transcendence. A simple definition of transcendence is existence or experience beyond the normal or physical level. They want to go up to the next level their own way. They don't want to do things the Creator's way, like I've said. They want to transcend their own way, and transhumanism looks to be the route they've been led to by Lucifer. A simple definition of transhumanism is the belief or theory that the human race can evolve beyond its current physical and mental limitations, especially by means of science and technology, which is clearly a bad idea. If you want a good idea, seek the love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in your heart. That's a good idea. Amen. Also, you see two cornerstones towards the back, one unrefined and the other refined. The Freemasons consider their hearts and their minds to be their cornerstone that they want to refine with sacred teachings as well as practices, and then they want to build their works upon that cornerstone. Jesus is, of course, the real cornerstone. The Masons have always wanted to create a new cornerstone. Lots of groups have been led by the enemy of humanity to try to create a new cornerstone. This is nothing new. In Acts 4:11 through 12, written about 2,000 years ago, it reads, "Jesus is the stone you builders rejected, which has become the cornerstone. Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved." Praise Jesus is all I can say about that. It's a blessing. You're blessed if you know he is the real cornerstone and you've accepted him as Lord in your life. But what are these builders who have rejected the true cornerstone helping build right now? New types of temples, new types of bodies, for one. For two, the beast system, including a one-world government and a one-world digital currency, just to name a few things. Also, Masons love the saying in Latin, Ordo ab cal, which means order out of chaos. Just like they create a black and a white, they also like to create chaos. And then likewise, they control and guide the situation until they have order. They showed us a little of this in the 2021 halftime show. They showed us chaos here. These people are chaotic. They are all confused. They can hardly function. And then later they showed us order. Here the people that were chaotic are marching together and organized, showing order, showing the new world order, satanic socialism, coming complete with a mark to buy and sell. But I got off track enough. Let's get back to this Z365 video. The next thing I wanted to point out here is that they show us this robot in a black and red outfit many times. Black and red have been said to be the colors associated with satanic control. You see black and red a lot with things like the Satanic Bible, Baphomet symbolism, and other types of satanic symbolism. Also, what I just showed you from the Super Bowl halftime show, these people were all wearing black and red outfits, right? The confused, chaotic people were under satanic control, and later on, marching together, they are shown to be under satanic control as well. And I might as well point out, with what they're wearing on their faces, they have no voice and no personal identity. This is how they are looked at by the powers that be. Just saying. But anyways, is it any surprise that this artificial intelligent robot is wearing the colors of satanic control? I definitely think they're showing us something there. Also, several times in this video, we see Katy Perry with Mark of the Beast symbolism on her forehead, with the whole screen in basically a black and red hue. Are the people who take the Mark of the Beast going to be under satanic control at some point? I think they will be. I think they will become host bodies for evil. And just a few more things I want to point out here. They show us this robot with a spiral hat. I don't think this is a coincidence either. The spiral is pretty prominent occult symbolism. I will read a description of the spiral in the occult real quick. The spiral, which is the oldest known symbol to be used in spiritual practices, reflects the universal pattern of growth and evolution. The spiral is a sacred symbol that reminds us of our evolving journey in life. When used as a personal talisman, the spiral helps consciousness to accept the turnings and changes of life as it evolves. The acceptance of change is one of the greatest freedoms a human can experience, putting consciousness in the present moment where the power of creation is condensed. On a larger scale, using this symbol assures all beings are reminded of their inward and outward evolution, a balanced and centered state of mind. On water, it carries the power to flow and change. So, this symbol has a lot to do with evolution and change, also embracing change, which is why I believe they put it here. I sometimes wonder too, if symbolism like this helps cast spells on an audience. Some people who seem like they're very, very asleep in life are almost like they've had a spell cast over them. Also, I've heard that the occult groups feel like they gain power or gain energy by putting symbolism in plain sight or the truth in plain sight. And moving on, next they show us this robot in bed with this man, trying to normalize sex bots again. Some men are already marrying robots in places like China, and for sure we will be seeing more of that. We will be seeing lots of people date and marry robots in our lifetime. The writing is definitely on the wall for that. And this thing is always watching this guy. It tries to watch him 24/7, 365. You hear that in the lyrics of this song and see it in the video, which is basically what AI is already trying to do in real life. And in this music video, this man is getting bothered by it, but there's not much he can do to escape it, something we will be seeing in our futures as well. Then they show us things go wrong here, and if you read the book of Daniel chapter 2 and focus on verse 43, the last kingdom of this earth age, before God has to wipe it all out, is described as being iron and clay. I do take iron as being machine, technology, and I take clay as being mankind. And here they're showing us man and machine. They're showing us iron and clay. And I'll read this verse real quick. It says, "And whereas thou sawest iron mixed with miry clay, they shall mingle themselves with the seed of men, but they shall not cleave one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay. And what shall mingle themselves with the seed of men? I've oftentimes asked myself when reading this verse, and it looks like something that isn't human, technology, something that isn't a fully organic life form, something that we will be told is better than us, something supposedly better than humans, from what we've been shown in so-called entertainment. Before the flood, it was fallen angels mingling themselves with human women, and I wouldn't be surprised if we did see fallen angels or Nephilim again in these last days. But right here, it looks like a synthetic life form is trying to cleave itself to man, or mingle itself with man. And things go wrong in this relationship. We see that here in this video. They show us some tribulation, and this thing tries to snuff this guy out. And I think that aligns with the Bible as well. They shall not cleave. Man and technology were never meant to mix together, like the powers that be are going to try to mix them together in the future. I mean, at some point, it looks like man and technology are going to want a divorce, and it's going to be a messy divorce. And when things go wrong with forbidden technology in the future, look what they are showing us here. These are people who are supposed to be paying attention to what's going on, and everyone here is asleep except for one person. You could say a very high percentage of people here are completely asleep when things go wrong, something I think we will see in the future as well, for sure. And after things go wrong here, the police come to save this man. But who is going to come to save what's left of mankind in the future when things go wrong? Are the human cops going to come and save humanity? No. Cops are going to need saving too. What happens is Jesus Christ has to return to break up things like this technology and the beast system and to save the remaining believers. And when he does return, it looks like things are pretty bad. And I'm not saying this stuff to try to scare people. I'm trying to present truth so people will draw close to the only one who can save them, Jesus Christ. Amen. And just looking at Matthew chapter 24, it covers a lot of the tribulation. And then it gets to verse 22, which reads, "And except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened." I think one of the reasons that there's almost no flesh left to save at that point is because many people have modified their bodies and don't count as human flesh anymore in God's eyes. Jesus said he would return when it was like in the days of Noah, and it looks like in the days of Noah, almost all flesh had been corrupted too. God's creation had been tampered with on a massive scale. Genesis 6:12 through 13 reads, "And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, The end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth." So what else can I say at this point but to stay close to the Lord and don't modify your body? And just one last clip of Katy Perry, and I just wanted to tell you too, to always be careful with mainstream entertainment and secular music. This is very demonic stuff, everything from Disney productions on up. And in this clip, I wanted to show you that it looks like Katy Perry manifests demon fangs, or at least they look like demon fangs to me. I'll slow it down even more, and maybe even play it frame by frame. But just look at her teeth. They look normal here, but then here they look like demon fangs. This happened while she was singing a terrible song called Peacock, and you might think it was a sexual innuendo at first when looking at the lyrics and everything, but this looks more demonic than anything. "There was a peacock-like demon, a spiritual entity, a false god, a lowercase g god in the Old Testament. His name was Adrimelech. He was mentioned in 2 Kings 17:31, and people used to make child sacrifices to him. He had a peacock-like appearance, as I said, and I do think it's possible they could have been invoking him or summoning him with this performance and similar performances. And if you're awake, you know that child sacrifices are still a huge, disgusting, bad problem, and that the mainstream media doesn't draw any attention to it. A lot of the things the elites are into are really bad. What else can I say? Really bad, all right? And they will be judged. Also, thinking about how there is a peacock-like demon, lowercase g god, related to child sacrifices, makes me think of the logo for NBC. Their logo is a peacock. Mainstream media in general is under the control of Lucifer. He is the prince of this domain for a time. I mean, you have the 666 in the Fox logo, you have the all-seeing eye in the CBS logo, just to give you a few examples. So I really hope you don't take the mainstream media as reliable truth. And that should be common sense. Mainstream media, mainstream history, and mainstream science are completely unreliable sources of information in general. In fact, if you want to learn how to resolve things in a more scientific way, just go home and study your Bible every day. Amen. And thanks for watching. God bless you and have a wonderful day in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'll leave you with just one more clip, just something to think about. It's an interesting clip. This is from the movie I, Robot. So enjoy, have a good one, and until next time, my friends.
This is the place where robots meet. Look, you can see them here as slaves to logic. And this man on the hill comes to free them. Do you know who he is?